Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Angular, and then I'll also show you how to create a simple Angular project in Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Angular and to create a simple Angular project, you need to first download Notejs. This is very important, guys. So for that, you know, just simply go to your favorite browser, and in here just simply type Notejs download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this Notejs.org is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on this download Note.js. This will automatically going to open official website of Node.js. If you just scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing this Windows installer, Mac installer, and source code. So if you're using Mac OS or Linux or any other OS, then you need to just simply proceed with that link. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to install Node.js for Windows. So for that, just simply click on this Windows installer. This will automatically going to start downloading Node.js. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Node version 14.16.1 has been directly downloaded over here, and the file size is only 28.8 MB. To install, just simply double click on it, and then if you just simply minimize my download directory, you can clearly see this Node JS setup wizard has been rightly open. So just simply click on next for installation, and now you need to first accept this license agreement. So for that, just simply check this, and then just simply click on next. This is going to be your installation destination, that is the C program files Node.js. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to simply click on change, and you can change that. But in this video, I am going to keep this all default, and then just simply click on next. And now under this custom setup is telling that this Node.js runtime going to be installed, and it will require this 53 MB of your C drive. For this npm package, you need to have at least 30 MB, and for online documentation you need to have just 1 KB, and to add path, this is very important. So this will automatically going to add your path inside your environment variable. So just keep this all default, and then just simply click on next. Now under this tools of native modules, it's depending upon you whether you'd like to check this. So this will automatically going to install this Chocolaty. In this video, I don't want to install this Chocolaty, so just simply uncheck that, and then just simply click on next. Now it's telling that it's ready to install Node.js, so just simply click on install for installation. This will automatically going to start installation. It's just 28 MB file, so it's going to be installed at a very rapid pace. And now as you can clearly see that this Node.js setup wizard has been rightly installed. So just simply click on finish. So now that your Node.js has been rightly installed, so just simply go to your command prompt, and in here if you just simply type node-v, then enter, you can clearly see that node version 14.16.1 has been rightly installed on your Windows 10 operating system. So first simply cancel this your command prompt, and in here just simply right click on it, and then just simply go to new, and then simply create a new folder. So let's give a folder name as Angular, and then just simply go inside that directory. So you are currently under this Angular directory. So in here, if you just simply open your command prompt, and here I'll show you how to install Angular. So for that, just simply type npm then space then install, and then minus g for global installation, then add it Angular, then slash CLI, that is this command line interface. So then enter. This will automatically going to start installing Angular, as you can clearly see that it's, you know, currently downloading your Angular package at the back end. So you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. So for which, you know, I'll be coming back after installing Angular. Yeah. So welcome back. And now, as you can clearly see, our Angular version 11.2.11 has been, you know, rightly installed. So Angular 11 is basically the, you know, the latest version. So now that you know your Angular has been, you know, rightly installed on your Windows 10 operating system, it's time to create a simple Angular project. So for that, if you just again simply type ng new, and then if you just give a name of your project, so let's give a name of your project as a Hello World. And then if you just, you know, simply click on enter, this will, you know, automatically, this Angular CLI is going to, you know, create a project for you. But for now, just, you know, simply type in, because I don't want to, you know, send any data to Google for the time now. So just, you know, simply press on enter. And now it's saying that whether we'd like to create any Angular routing. Routing is basically, you know, what you used to see in the URL. So let's say you are, you know, changing from your message to your home, then it will, you know, going to say that you are, you know, currently in home or your email message. So all those things, you know, usually happen by, you know, this routing. As you all know that Angular basically helps to create a single page application. So ultimately, with the help of routing, you just know that how that page is, you know, inside that what directory and all. So, you know, it's very important to, you know, give to add this routing. So for the time being, you know, just, you know, simply type Y and then enter. And now it's saying that what type of CSS format we'd like to use. So CSS mean, I mean this style sheet. So, you know, I just want .css file. So just, you know, simply select .css, this CSS, and then, you know, just simply click on enter. This will, you know, automatically going to start creating your Angular project. This might take some time, maybe, you know, about 3 to 4 minutes. So what I'll be doing is, you know, I'll be coming back after this process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can clearly see that our Hello World project has been, you know, rightly created and is, you know, telling that Git is not recognized as an internal or an external command. So this is mainly because Git is not installed on my machine right now. I am going to show you how to install Git in my next video. So now to run this project, so, you know, just simply type ng sub. Sorry guys, I just forgot to go inside that, you know, project. So you need to first, you know, simply type cd Hello World. So you need to first go inside that project that, you know, just created. So now that, you know, you are currently inside this Hello World, so if you just now simply type ng serve, then enter, this will, you know, automatically going to start your Node.js module. Now for the time being, just, you know, simply type in and enter, so that, you know, I don't want to send any analytical data to Google. And this will, you know, your Node.js engine is, you know, going to start at the back end. This will, you know, help to create a server using which you can run your Angular project in the browser. It will again, you know, take some time. So, you know, I'll be also going to come back after this end of process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can clearly see that our project is now currently live at our local host. So this is the link, that is this http localhost colon 4200, where, you know, your project has been, you know, rightly hosted. So if you just go to your browser, and in here if you just type localhost 4200, then enter, you'll be seeing your Angular project Hello World has been, you know, rightly shown, and our project title is Hello World, app is now, you know, currently running. So in this way, you install Angular in a Windows 10 operating system. And then I have also shown you how to create a simple Angular project. And then I have also shown you how to run a simple Angular project. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.